Hello everyone and welcome to another video. In this video, I'll be giving a brief overview of some of the features of the Comset CM685VX 5G router. So first, let's take a look at what comes in the box.
Besides the Comset CM685VX router, you'll also receive a Cat5e Ethernet cable, a serial cable, a 12-volt DC power supply, two Wi-Fi antennas, and four 5G cellular antennas. Next, let's take a look at the SIM card. When you first get your SIM card from your provider, it should look something like this. To get it out of the packaging, just give it a good push, and this will leave you with the standard size SIM card, which is sometimes known as the mini or the regular size SIM. If you look closely, you can also see that this can be adapted to the micro and the nano size SIMs, simply by pushing the desired size out. The nano size SIM card is probably the most common size today. You see it a lot in things like mobile phones. However, using the nano or the micro size SIM in the CM685VX or any of the Comset routers can really damage the SIM slots. So it's very important that we use the standard size SIM. Now to insert this SIM card, turn this router over and then take off this back panel. Once you've taken the panel off, go ahead and slide this slot to the left and then lift it up and then take your SIM card and slide it into place, making sure that this notched edge is at this corner. And then push it back down and slide it to the right until it locks into place. Then we can put the panel back on. Next, we're going to have a look at the antennas of this router. As I mentioned before, this router comes with two Wi-Fi antennas, which you can attach either side here and here. Now this Wi-Fi meets the N300 standard, which means it supports a frequency of 2.4 GHz, so it can offer a wider range of Wi-Fi coverage, and it can reach speeds of up to 300 megabits per second. And it also comes with four 5G antennas. Now the CM685VX router supports 4x4 MIMO, unlike our 4G routers, which support 2x2. So this means you'll have to attach all four 5G antennas, which you can find two at the front and then two on the side. If you find that the provided antennas don't offer a strong enough signal in your area, you can also attach external high gain antennas instead. So to attach one of these antennas, you simply twist it on until it's nice and secure. And with these particular antennas, just fold them up like so. Lastly, we're going to have a look at the other physical interfaces on this router. If we have a look at the front of our router, we can see that we have both a LAN port and a WAN port. Now, both of these support gigabit Ethernet for faster speeds. You can use the LAN side to connect locally to devices, such as to your PC for configuration, or to devices like IP cameras. And you can use the WAN side to connect to outside of your local network, such as to the NBN. You can also configure this WAN port to act as a LAN instead, which we've covered in another video. Moving on to the other end, you can see we have the DC jack, which you can connect to the 12-volt DC power supply to power the router. And this is just one method you can use to supply power. We also have on the terminal block, the VCC and the ground pins. The VCC pin can be connected to a voltage between 5 and 40 volts DC, and the ground must be connected to ground. You can also use the terminal block for serial communication using RS-232. For this, we have the TX, the RX, and the ground pins. Now be careful not to get this ground pin for serial communication mixed up with the ground pin for the power supply. Next along we have the reset pin. You can use this to reset the router by shorting the reset with the ground for the power supply for 3 seconds. However, it's just as easy to hold down this button on the front for 12 seconds to reset the router. So after the reset pin, we then have four pins for general purpose digital input and output. This means that all four of these pins can be used as either inputs, connected to some kind of sensor, or outputs connected to something like lights or a motor. Okay, so that covers the basic hardware features of the CM685VX router. If you want to learn how to configure this router or how to set up specific features like VPNs or SMS commands, be sure to check out our other tutorial videos. And that's all for this video. Thank you all for watching. See you in the next one.